Hello, tis me again. I haven't made a book video in a while, but today I want to talk about a book, a very special book. It is called 100 Days of Sunlight, and it's by Abby Emmons. I think maybe a lot of people who watch this video already know, but if you don't know, Abby Emmons makes videos on YouTube about writing and about motivation, and I gotta say, her videos help me a ton. Whenever I'm done watching one of her videos, I just feel like I have to write. And it's just helped me a lot in like motivating me to actually write and get stuff done with my writing. So just in case you don't know who she is, just like go watch her videos. She's great. She's wonderful. So when I heard she was publishing her first book, I got super excited. I'm so happy for her. I'm so excited for her. And I applied for an ARC and I got the ARC and I read the ARC and now I'm reviewing it. As a disclaimer, I just want to say that all the opinions that I have in this video are completely true. I am not sugarcoating anything in this video just because she's a YouTuber that I like. Because I've read some YouTuber books that I have not liked, and my reviews of those have not been sugarcoated either. So, just a disclaimer, everything I say is 100% how I felt about reading this book. So, let's get into the review. 100 Days of Sunlight is a YA contemporary about a 16-year-old girl named Tessa. One day she is in a car accident and she temporarily loses her sight. She is a poet and a blogger, and so losing her sight really devastates her, and just she's not doing well. Then in comes Weston. He is hired, against Tessa's will, might I add, to help keep her blog running while she's blind. Weston is everything that Tessa is not. He is rambunctious and loud and mind-bogglingly optimistic, and also he has no legs. Tessa doesn't know this about Weston, and because she's blind, she can't tell, and Weston is not planning on telling her that he doesn't have legs either. And the story just follows their summer together, as Weston helps Tessa in more ways than she could have ever imagined. This story is so cute! I gotta say, this is probably the cutest book I've ever read. Like, when I think about this book, I just feel all warm and fuzzy inside. It's very summery and bright. I mean, the title is... Now, I gotta say, I don't often read YA contemporary novels that involve a lot of romance. This is just me, but like, if it's too mushy and fluffy, I like easily find it cringy, and I easily just don't like that. And this book is mushy, let me tell you. It is so fluffy and cute and adorable, and for some reason I was completely on board with it. Like, there were a few parts that were a little too much for me and a little too heavy on the mushy cute stuff, but overall, like, I thought it was just done really well and it didn't bother me as much as it usually does. And I think a lot of that has to do with the characters and the character arcs. But I'll get into that later. So I will say, it is very romancy, it's very cutesy. If you're not into that, maybe this is not the book for you. But of course, a lot of people are really into that, and if you are into that, like, this is the book for you. Let me tell you. The story is just really clever, and it's really cleverly done as well. Amputee gets blind girl over her blindness is just such a good concept. The story immediately drew me in. I remember I just sat down and started reading it one morning, and before I knew it, I was 100 pages in. And let me tell you, that does not happen often for me when I read, because I'm a really slow reader. I just flew through it. I devoured this book. It felt as a really quick read, and it kept me interested and wanting more the whole way through. Like, there was not a dull part. And it's so sweet. Like, if I had to describe this book in three words, I would say adorable, sweet, sunlight. Honestly, like, the title's really well chosen. Also, the themes of this book really drew me in. You know, there's themes of resilience, optimism, self-improvement, persistence. Like, these are things that I'm really into as a person, and that's also why I was so excited to read this book. It's like, I knew it was gonna be good because I've seen her YouTube videos and they're also like really about like self-improvement and motivation and stuff. So like, I was hoping that there would be like similar stuff in this novel, and there are, and I just like, that's just something I really love, because you have here these two characters who are dealing with quite like difficult things to deal with. Losing your sight, losing a limb is very hard, and like how to get back up from that and how to just overcome hardship. I love those kinds of stories. And I think it's really well done here because themes like that can easily start to feel cliched because we've all heard the same slogans before. You know, those like typical motivational sentences. You know, it can get quite cliche easily, but I truly feel like this book had something really beautiful and meaningful to say, and I'm so glad that I read it. I think the characters here are really well-rounded, and I think that's what helped me get through the romance-y parts, because I felt their story. They feel like people with assets and flaws. I was also very happy that the minor characters had a lot of depth as well. Like, I could envision these people, these quite minor characters, so well. That's always something I appreciate, because I often notice that minor characters are just quite one-dimensional, and in this case, that wasn't the case, so I was quite happy about that. And let me tell you about my favorite character. Weston is like everything to me. At first, I thought he was gonna be like too perfect, you know, and I was like, but like, he's not. He's a really well-rounded, well-written character, but like, still, like, I love him. Oh, I feel like everybody needs a Weston in their life. I wish I had a Weston in my life. He is so lovable, and the dynamic between Tessa and Weston, who are just so different but can kind of get along in this weird in-between space, I just thought that was really beautiful. I love those types of stories where the characters go from hating each other to liking each other. Real nice. The writing itself was really beautiful at certain parts, almost like it gets poetic, but not like in a pretentious, too complex way, but just like there's some really beautiful sentences in the book that I wish I could have highlighted because they were just nicely worded. Some parts of the dialogue felt, I don't know how to really describe it. I think it's because we were dealing with like 16-year-olds. You know, they're high school students, so they talk like high school students, and there were just like stretches of, you know, just dialogue of these like high school students. I had it especially when Tessa was talking to her female friends. Maybe I'm just old, but like, to me, like, some of that dialogue felt cringy, but I think it's just because like young people talk like that. And so, like, it's realistic. Maybe it's just because sometimes there was just dialogue. Like, maybe just too much, like, long stretches of dialogue. That was a small, this tiny little point I did have. Basically, I'm old. Oh. But anyways, all in all, I would give this book a 4 out of 5 stars. I think it's great. I think the story is so beautiful. What I like about it the most is, well, A, Weston, I'm in love with Weston. Like, I want my son to be like Weston. And just like the uplifting message that this book has. This book really leaves you feeling so light and easy breezy, beautiful cover girl. You know, like, reading this book, you feel like you can do anything. It's almost like a motivational self-help book, but like in the form of a cute romance, which isn't that just, like, doesn't that sound good? That, like, I feel like that's what a lot of people would love to read. And if that's what you want to read, this is the book for you. Like, just now when I think back to this book, all I can do is just smile because it's just so cute, and it's so motivational. So I don't know, this is definitely a book I'm gonna want to reread for sure. It's probably gonna be one of those typical summer rereads. I do believe this is a summer book. Like, you gotta read this in summer. So like, it's coming out on August 7th, I believe. That's summer. Buy the book. Read the book in summer. Yeah, I think that kind of wraps it up. Basically, I really, really love this book. It's one of my favorite books that I've read this year. It's just one of those books that I'm always gonna just like, it's always gonna bring a smile to my face, and this book just makes me happy. Anyways, that's gonna be all for me today. Yeah, I hope you have a wonderful day, and I will see you in the next video. Goodbye.